So you found a list about the software development position job that you would like to get, and you have been preparing for a while, and you think you're ready for a technical interview. But you're not sure what to expect, what are the different types of technical interviews, how's the technical interview process for this company. Also, as an interviewer, you're not sure how to get the best candidate. I'm starting now a new series of videos where I'll be covering the different types of technical interviews that are most seen on the market and that I have experienced myself, either as a candidate or as an interviewer during my career. I will be explaining what are these different types of technical interviews and also giving you some tips and showing you the pros and cons of each of them, both as a candidate and as an interviewer. During this series of videos, I will be covering the screening interview, the technical knowledge test, the take-home test, the live coding, and some other types of technical interviews. I'm Christian, and you're watching A Dev Story, and today we're going to start with the screening interview. The technical screening interview is always the first interview that you get on any interviewing process. It's usually a short interview of about 30 minutes, and it can either be a simple programming exercise like SpaceBus or some computer science fundamentals questions like what are sum sorting algorithms, what is the time complexity of merge sort, how does binary search works. The screening interview can be either automated or performed by a person. When it's automated, it's usually done through one of the websites that handle this type of test, for example, HackerRank or Codility or LeetCode and the likes. And on these sites, you will get a programming exercise and a time limit that you need to complete the exercise. And once you finish it, if it's correct, then you pass the interview, otherwise you fail it. Some of the pros of the screening interview for the interviewer is basically that it's a quick filtering for unprepared candidates, which is not the same as unqualified candidates. And it can be performed by non-developers or even outsourced to other companies. As a candidate, it's a little time investment where you already get to see some of the parts of the company. If you get interviewed by a person, then you get that chance of asking additional questions about the interview process too. Also, as a candidate, if you struggle during the screening interview and you still pass it, then you know that you need to prepare more for the next steps in the interview process. The main con of this type of interviews for the interviewer is trying to maintain the candidate experience. This is the first time that the person contacts the company and one is really excited about joining your company, and sometimes you might be facing them against a tool, an automated tool that even could be outside the company like HackerRank or Codility, and that can put some people off. And maybe if they didn't know that exercise or they failed that exercise, that could be a bad experience for the candidate. So keeping the experience might be the main challenge for this interview. And as a candidate, the main con that you have is that you have little leeway and you don't have too much flexibility on what you can answer. If you get the automated test, then you need to reply exactly by completing that programming exercise. And if you get the technical questions done by a person, that person might not be very technical. And even if you explain some of the details of the solution, you might need to reply with the exact answer that the person is asking you. And we will see that in a moment. For example, if as a candidate you get asked, what is the time complexity of merge sort? Then you might want to reply like, so the way that merge sort works is that you get an array and you split it and you keep splitting each of the subarrays. Yeah, when you merge it back, well, I don't know exactly if we have to multiply n or log n, but you know, like this is the full way that the merge sort works. That isn't the right answer, because even when you know the whole algorithm and how it works, the person that is asking you the question might not know those details. So you need to reply more like this. The time complexity for merge sort is n log n, where n is the number of elements. So that's the type of answer that is expected during the screening interview. So now let's get to the tips. As an interviewer, the main tip is to try to keep the candidate experience or to have a great candidate experience and make sure that candidates are not discouraged to keep applying by getting an automated machine or something like that. Maybe a person could contact them the first time and then you can send them to the automated test. Maybe the automated test has different options, these type of things. My first tip for the candidates is to know the most about the screening interview in the company that you're applying for. you can get this information from Glassdoor, or you can ask the first contact that you get from the company. If the company does automated programming exercises, then try to practice these exercises in sites like I mentioned before, HackerRank or Codility or LeetCode and the likes. And it's always valuable, especially for big tech companies, to review the computer science fundamentals. And you can get this information, for example, from my summary guides that you can get downloaded for free in the description below. You can also check my playlist, and of course there are books that you can get. And there is plenty of resources on the internet. I'm just pointing to some of them. After you pass the screening interview, you will get into later stages of the interview process. In the later stages, you might see the other type of interviews that I mentioned before. You can get the technical knowledge test, or the live coding, or the take-home test. So keep watching the series if you want to know more. But now let me know, what do you think about the screening interview? Have you experienced anything weird during this type of interviews? Anything that I'm missing? Maybe something that could have been improved? Let me know what you think about in the comments. And that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.